In Beaver today, a judge is deliberating whether animal welfare activists can offer a unique type of defense for the crimes they're accused of.
It involves a high-profile break-in at a factory farm in Milford. Fox 13's Ben Winslow has more.
The Utah Attorney General's office is asking a judge to block a pair of activists from offering a justification of their actions or even showing a jury a video of it. Members of the group Direct Action Everywhere are facing charges of burglary and theft. They're charged with breaking into Smithfield Foods' Circle 4 Farms in Milford back in 2018 and taking a pair of piglets. The group posted video of it all online.
In reality, this is about preventing the public from finding out what's happening behind Smithfield's closed door.
Wayne Chung is among those charged. The Utah Attorney General's office has filed a motion to limit any discussion of the conditions in the farm and block the entire video from being shown to a jury. The state says allowing the defense to have discussion of the conditions of animals would mislead the jury and appeal to undue passions. The Attorney General's office goes on to say the court would be left to instruct the jury that references to those conditions and the ultimate plight is not a defense to criminal conduct, leaving the jury confused.
Their main intention has been to stop us from criticizing Smithfield. And this is part of a broader pattern, including the state ag gag law, where the industry has tried to suppress accurate, truthful information about the horrible conditions animals are enduring and the real risk to public health.
The Utah Attorney General's office declined to comment, but its filings show it's trying to limit the defense to whether or not the activists broke into the farm, something that's clearly on video.
And what the prosecution is doing is really an attack on whistleblowers, not just animal rights activists.
In court, defense attorneys questioned why the state would want to exclude the video of the burglary itself because they're worried about a jury's feelings.
I think normal people can watch that without going completely bananas.
To allow the parties to hand select still photos in place of the video.
The judge says she'll consider the arguments before making a ruling.
The court does not intend to make any decisions based upon the embarrassment of a particular party or convenience or anything that is not a legally sound basis.
The activists are pushing for a jury trial. Now, another interesting thing came out of court today. The defense is asking the judge to force Utah Attorney General Sean Reyes himself to issue a declaration about whether anyone from Smithfield Foods has contributed to his political campaigns. On the Hill, Ben Winslow, Fox 13 News, Utah.
Utah does have a mixed history of the necessity defense. It's most commonly used in self-defense cases, but some legal actions include a woman who tried to use it when she was convicted of vandalizing the Utah State Capitol to call attention to homeless issues. Environmental activist Tim DeChristopher tried to use it in federal court after he was convicted of sabotaging an oil and gas auction. He was blocked from calling attention to climate change. Now, prior to Utah's medical cannabis laws, it was also cited for marijuana possession for people who claim to be patients.